Hey, it's Allison from Computers.mom, and today's video will show you how to use screen sharing for remote tech support on Macs. Screen sharing is an app made by Apple for Mac computers. It's free and it's easy to use. Screen sharing allows one person, the helper, to remotely access the Mac of someone who needs help, that's the sharer. It's a fantastic way to help friends and family with their tech issues without having to travel. This video will show you how to use it whether you're the helper or the sharer. And as usual, you'll find a quick recap of the key steps at the end of the video for your convenience, so there's no need to take notes. Before we start, let's just be crystal clear that you should never ever let someone access your computer remotely unless you know and trust them. Remote access tools are often used by scammers pretending to be legitimate tech support. Rule of thumb, if you wouldn't give the person your house keys, you shouldn't let them into your computer. Let's start with the requirements, which are pretty basic. Both the helper and the sharer will need an Apple computer running a recent version of macOS, ideally macOS Sonoma 14 or later. If you're not sure which version of macOS you have, just click the Apple menu and About This Mac. The answer is right here in the window that pops up. This Mac is running Ventura, not Sonoma, but that's good enough. It will still work. The second thing you'll both need, of course, is internet access. You can't connect unless you're both online. You'll both need to be signed into iCloud, and the helper will need the sharer's Apple ID. These last two items can be checked on your Mac very easily. All you need to do is click the Apple, System Settings, and then the person's name, and the Apple ID is right here. So now that you have your ducks in a row, let's see how this works. We're looking at the helper's computer. The helper starts by opening the screen sharing app. To find it, just open Spotlight Search from the menu bar up here, begin typing the word screen, and select the screen sharing app from the list that appears. Once the app is open, you will see a list of previous screen sharing sessions. You can click on a name in the list to start a new share with them, or for a new screen share, click the plus sign and type the Apple ID of the sharer. If the person's in your iCloud contacts, you'll see their name pop up automatically. Then click Connect and wait for the sharer to accept your request. If they don't respond within a few minutes, the request will time out and you'll need to try again. Now let's flip over to the sharer's computer. On the sharer's side, a dialog box pops up letting the sharer know that you are asking for permission to see their screen. Move the pointer to that alert and click Options. Now there are three choices: accept, decline, or block user. When we accept, we have another choice to make: let the person control my screen or just observe the screen. Let's say the sharer is feeling cautious and only wants to let the helper observe. We change the selection to observe and click accept again. Once we do, a little notification pops up at the top of the screen alerting you that your screen is being shared and that your microphone is in use. That's really helpful because as long as you both have the sound on, you can talk to each other right in the app. You don't have to be on the phone as well. Back on the helper side, as soon as the sharer accepts, the helper can see the sharer's desktop in the screen sharing window. And since the window is not full screen, we can see a bit of the helper's desktop behind it. Let's make the window a little smaller. So now the helper can see what's going on the sharer's computer and tell the sharer what to do if you both have the patience for that. If not, the helper can click here to request control of the sharer's screen. The sharer will then see a new request pop up and they can accept it or just ignore it. Let's accept it. Now the helper can control the sharer's computer directly, almost as if they were sitting in front of it without having to physically be there. The sharer can also control their computer, but only one of you can control it at a time. You have to take turns. Notice the controls across the top of the window on the helper's side. These give you quick access to certain options and apps. Hover over one to see what it is, or try clicking them to see what they do, like these zoom in and out buttons. You can copy and paste between the two computers, so long as the Share Clipboard option is checked here on the Edit menu. And you can even move files and folders between them simply by dragging them from one to the other. When you're done, you can end the screen share on the helper side by clicking the Close button or quitting the app, or on the sharer's side by clicking on the menu bar icon here and selecting End Screen Sharing. One final tip, if you text each other from the Messages app on your computers, You can also start screen sharing right from the Messages window. Just select a conversation with the person, click the Info button up here, then Share, and then select one of the options. Invite to share my screen if you are the sharer, or Ask to share screen if you're the helper. It's a quick and easy way to start screen sharing, and either one of you can initiate the session. That's all there is to it. As promised, here's a quick recap of the key steps. The helper opens the screen sharing app, clicks the plus sign, types in the sharer's Apple ID, and clicks Connect. The sharer accepts the connection and then chooses either Control or Observe mode and accepts again. Alternatively, open the Messages app, select a conversation with the person, click the Info button, then Share, then Invite or Ask as appropriate. This method is faster, but requires that you both use Messages on your computers. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave us comments and questions. Click like if you found this helpful, and don't forget to subscribe for more Computers.mom videos.